Hello and welcome. Following the relative success of Starlink, there have been multiple upshots who are positioning themselves to give Starlink a serious competition. In this video, I'm going to share 10 of them. Watch to the end for a bonus mention. The first one is OneWeb from the United Kingdom. OneWeb aims to provide global broadband internet via a constellation of approximately 648 LEO satellites, with hundreds already launched. It focuses on serving rural and underserved areas, partnering with governments and businesses, and emerged from bankruptcy in 2020 with the UK government and Bharti Global backing. The second one is Project Kuiper from the United States. Amazon's Project Kuiper plans to deploy 3,236 low Earth orbit satellites to deliver high-speed internet, though it has yet to launch operational satellites as of March 2025. It leverages Amazon's vast resources and aims to compete with Starlink, with initial prototype launches scheduled for very soon. Number three is Telesat Lightspeed from Canada. Telesat Lightspeed is a planned constellation of around 188 to 298 low-Earth orbit satellites designed to offer low-latency, high-capacity internet for businesses, governments, and remote regions. The project, backed by a $5 billion investment, expects to begin launches in 2026, building on Telesat's existing geostationary satellite expertise. AST SpaceMobile from the United States. AST SpaceMobile is developing a unique low Earth orbit network to provide 4G and 5G connectivity directly to standard smartphones, with its first commercial satellites in progress. It has partnerships with major telecoms like AT&T and Vodafone, aimed to bridge cellular coverage gaps globally. Qianfan, China. Qianfan, also known as G60 Starlink, is China's ambitious low Earth orbit constellation project, targeting over 10,000 satellites to rival Starlink, with initial launches underway by 2025. Led by Shanghai Spacecom, it seeks to provide broadband and support China's space infrastructure goals. SpaceSail, China. SpaceSail is another Chinese low Earth orbit initiative, part of the global Guawan plan, aiming for thousands of satellites to deliver internet and communication services. Details are sparse, but it reflects China's push to compete in the global satellite internet race along with Qianfan. Jio, India. Jio, through its JioSpaceFiber venture with SES, plans to use medium Earth orbit and potentially low Earth orbit satellites to extend gigabit internet across India, targeting rural areas. It builds on Reliance Jio's massive terrestrial network, with services announced in 2023 and expansion ongoing. Plan S, Turkey. Plan S is a Turkish startup working on a small low Earth orbit constellation for Internet of Things and narrowband data services, with initial test satellites launched by 2025. It aims to expand into broader connectivity solutions, leveraging Turkey's growing aerospace sector. Hellospace, Turkey. Hellospace focuses on narrowband data communication via a planned low Earth orbit constellation, offering global coverage for Internet of Things and messaging services. It's an early-stage project with limited satellites deployed, emphasizing cost-effective space solutions. Fergani Uzay, Technology Leri, another upstart from Turkey. Fergani Uzay, founded in 2022, is developing low Earth orbit satellites and components for commercial use, with a focus on innovative propulsion technology. It's part of Turkey's emerging new space industry, aiming for sustainable and affordable space services. And now, time for the bonus mention. IRIS² – The European Union. The European Union is developing a low Earth orbit satellite constellation known as IRIS² – Infrastructure for Resilience, Interconnectivity and Security by Satellite. It aims to deploy about 290 low Earth orbit and medium Earth orbit satellites to provide secure, high-speed internet and encrypted communication services across Europe and beyond, with initial operations targeted for 2030. The $10.5 billion project, funded by the EU, member states, and private industry, seeks to reduce reliance on foreign systems like Starlink, while enhancing strategic autonomy and supporting applications like government communications, disaster response, and broadband access in remote areas. Thanks for watching this far. Cheers.